Today, the second day of the Novena to the Holy Spirit as a preparation for our Pentecost, we meditate upon and pray for the second fruit of the Holy Spirit, joy. Joy, which is the fruit of the Holy Spirit, is not the joy and happiness that we get because of our success or being favored by somebody else or any gifts that we receive or the prosperity in our life, but it is a supernatural joy infused within us, instilled within us by the Holy Spirit. The Greek word used for happiness or joy is chara, and word chara is closely associated with another Greek word charis, and charis means grace. So joy, which is the fruit of the Holy Spirit, is a result of divine grace within us. A person who has fullness of divine grace also will experience the joy of the Holy Spirit. So if anybody loses that grace, that can affect the joy in our heart. So sin can really take away the joy from our heart. Lamentations chapter 5 verse 15 and 16 says, "The joy of my heart is lost. My dance has turned into mourning. The crown has fallen off my head. Woe to me because I have sinned." So sin takes away the joy of my heart and my dance is turned into mourning. But when we repent of our sins and get converted and come back to God, we can receive back that joy that we have lost. In Psalm 51 verse 13 and 14, David, after committing adultery with Bathsheba, he repented of his sins. Out of his repentant heart came the Psalm 51. And 13 and 14, he says, "Do not drive me from your presence, nor take from me the Holy Spirit. Restore my joy in your salvation. Sustain in me a willing spirit." So he connects the joy of the Holy Spirit to his conversion and repentant heart. The Gospel according to Saint Luke chapter 15, we have three parables. The parable of the lost sheep, parable of the lost coin, and the parable of the prodigal son. The first two parables are concluded by Jesus saying, there will be more joy in heaven in the coming back of a sinner than about a righteous person. The third parable is concluded with the celebration of a feast in the family of the prodigal son, and the whole household rejoiced in the coming back of the son. When the elder son questions the preparation of the feast by the father says, "We lost him, today we got him back. Should we not rejoice?" So heaven rejoices the coming back of a sinner, and the sinner also shares that inner joy. And joy, which is a fruit of the Holy Spirit, is a joy we get when we are in the presence of God. 1 Chronicles chapter 16 verse 27, "Splendor and majesty are before him, strength and joy." So joy comes from the presence of God. When we are in the presence of God, encompassing presence of God, then we experience the inner joy. It is the experience of a righteous person, an upright person, and who keeps the commandments. Psalm 32 verse 11, "Be glad in the Lord and rejoice, O righteous, and shout for joy, all who are upright in heart." So when we lead a righteous life, obeying the commandments of God, when we are closer to God, the Holy Spirit gives us that inner joy. It is the joy of those who take refuge in God. When we are in trouble, when we take refuge in God, that gives us joy because God always protects us. Psalm 5:11. But let all who take refuge in you rejoice. Let take refuge in you rejoice. Let them ever sing for joy. So those who take refuge in God will always be able to enjoy the heavenly happiness given by the Holy Spirit. It is a joy even in the midst of persecution. A person who is filled with the Holy Spirit will be able to rejoice even in the midst of persecution. As we read in the book of Acts chapter 5 verse 41. They left the presence of the Sanhedrin rejoicing that they had been found worthy to suffer dishonor for the sake of the name. When the disciples were persecuted and they were arrested and questioned and beaten, they were happy in sharing the suffering of Jesus. Then it is a joy even in the midst of failures and poverty. Habakkuk chapter 3 verse 17 and 18. For though the fig tree blossom not, nor fruit be on the vines, though the yield of the olive fail, though the flock disappear from the fold, and there is no herd in the stalls, yet I will rejoice in the Lord. So even if my crop fails, even if my efforts fail, even if I encounter failures in my life, still I praise God. That gives me joy. It is the hallmark of every Christian. So Saint Paul instructs all Christians to rejoice in the Lord. And again I say rejoice. Philippians chapter 4 verse 4. And it is a sign of the coming of the kingdom of God. Romans chapter 14 verse 17. For the kingdom of God is not a matter of eating and drinking, but of righteousness and peace and joy in the Holy Spirit. So a person who is filled with the Holy Spirit will enjoy that heavenly happiness, that joy, and that is a sign of the coming of the kingdom of God. And so when we rejoice in the Lord, when we experience the joy in our hearts, we'll be able to radiate that love, radiate that joy to others, radiate that happiness to others, then we will become a source of joy for others. That is how we produce the fruit of the Holy Spirit joy. Let's pray for that to the loving Lord. God, the Holy Spirit, the Spirit of joy and consolation, we ask you to fill our hearts with a divine joy, that we may be able to rejoice always in the midst of sufferings, sickness, deprivations, persecutions, famine, troubles, temptations, and trials. Let that joy radiate around us. All those people who come into contact with us also may be able to experience the joy of the Holy Spirit. Make us a channel and medium of divine joy so that when we interact with others, this joy may be transmitted to them. They also experience the inner joy. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen. Now, in union with the Holy Pope, all bishops, all priests, religious, and the whole Holy Catholic Church, I bless all of you. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. May God bless you.